Guys, what's going on? Welcome to Serial at Midnight. My name is Heath, and I'm joined today by James, the comic book savant. James, what's going on, man?
Hey, everybody. How you doing?
So we're going to be talking about a topic that I think a lot of us are thinking about, and that is the theater experience versus the home theater experience. Because I think more and more, the theatrical experience is becoming less appealing to a lot of us, and the home theater experience is becoming more appealing to a lot of us. The model is shifting, but there's a lot of conversation to be had there. So we're going to dive in. James, you still go to the theater kind of a lot, right?
I do. It's slowed down in 2019. 2018, I jumped on the Movie Pass bandwagon. I was ripping that thing, man. I was like, I used it a lot. So I was at the movie theaters quite. I like tripled my output for movies from 2017 to 2018. I at least tripled. I went to so many movies. So, yeah.
Whereas I, on the other hand, used to go to the movies like 2 to 3 times a week, and it's just tapered off and tapered off. And now it's like 3 to 4 times a year, because for me, it's just not a fun experience. And the theatrical experience itself has changed. And we've talked about it before. I know on your channel, your podcast, your YouTube channel, you've talked before about, like, you've gotten feedback from people and been like, do you still like going to the movies? And I think more and more people are being like, no, I don't like going anymore, because I know for me, it's just not the same experience that it used to be. People are less considerate than they used to be. And it really, like, every time we go, my wife is going to get kicked in the back of the head. Like, every time. It's not even a question. She's going to get kicked in the back of the head. Someone's going to answer a phone call in the middle of the movie. Not like it's going to ring and they're going to be like, oh, I'm sorry. They're going to take it out and talk on the phone. I don't think that that's just a local thing for me. I think that that's kind of happening all over the place. Just the communal experience, first and foremost, the community that we have, it's kind of changing, and it's more like me, and less of a shared experience. Do you see any of that at your theater?
It's been a change for me, because the past 4.5, going on 5 years now, I relocated to Texas, and it's been a different experience. Now, before I left North Carolina, where I lived for a number of years, 20 some odd years, I was noticing more of those kind of experiences at the tail end of me going to movies there. Now, my wife exposed me to a theater chain called Studio Movie Grill that's based out of Texas, but they have locations spread all around the country in about 10 to 13 states, I believe, where it's the dine-in theater experience. And they, which people tend to think is pricier, but they're really not that expensive as a movie theater, because they're making their money off of drinks and food. So the movie tickets are actually reasonably priced. And what I find out through most people, even when I was having conversations with you, is sometimes the tickets, what I pay for a ticket, is cheaper than what you pay, even for like early morning matinees. You know, the experience here, because I'm go to that kind of theater, and it's really the only kind of, it's the main theater I go to for like 95% of my movies. I've been to only one other theater chain in Texas since I've been here. It was a horrible experience. And it was a Regal cinema, and it was horrible. Nice theater, but like you said, the communal experience was horrible. And I visited one of my friends in Chicago, and we went to an AMC theater. Yeah. And it was an abysmal, and it was so, for the money we spent, the experience was horrible.
Here where I am, AMC has, in the last like 2 years, maybe even the last 1 year, I think I noticed it around the time of Solo, A Star Wars Story, they, like, AMC has bought up all the chains in our town. And so now everything's in AMC. And I mean, I didn't think it could get worse from what it was, but it absolutely did. And it, like, they're pushing their priority memberships and stuff. So if you want to get popcorn in a shorter line, that's a premium experience now. Crazy stuff, just really crazy stuff. The ticket prices are through the roof. Like, a matinee for us is $10 just for a 2D movie. It's crazy. So the price, I've brought up price. So that's kind of the other thing, is like the windows for these movies coming to like home theater are shorter than they've ever been. So like I could go see, you know, like I myself could go see Aquaman or something at a matinee for $10, or Like, that movie just came out a couple of months ago, right? Like, seriously, like 3 months ago, I
think. December. Came out in December. Yeah.
Okay, so around the same time as Into the Spider-Verse. And I just, I have some notes here. Like, I was looking on the price site that I look at for Blu-ray. Blu-ray.com shows price drops and stuff. So currently, Aquaman, Into the Spider-Verse, Venom, Mission Impossible, Fallout, all of those movies, Creed 2, all of those are $15 or less right now on Blu-ray. Yeah. So, I mean, like, it's almost like they want us, they're like, don't bother coming to the theater right now. You can buy it for cheaper and then you can just own it. And so it's really becoming a question of, and I know for you, you're not necessarily into the Blu-rays, you're more digital, but the same situation, I imagine they're about the same price digitally.
Right. So, I literally just bought Aquaman Friday for $12.99 digitally on iTunes. It was a sale. I think it was selling for $20. They put it on sale Friday for $12.99. I got it for $12.99.
Yeah. And, you know, I was noticing, like, on the Blu-ray, I don't know about the digital, but on the Blu-ray of Into the Spider-Verse, it's got, like, an alternate mode where you can watch it where it tells you the Easter egg. It's like, it's kind of like alternate reality or the Spider-Verse mode or something. And they show you all the Easter eggs in the movie.
I haven't checked the special features on it yet. I need to.
Okay.
Now I gotta look at that. Thank you.
I mean, it had like an hour of behind the scenes footage and stuff. And then it had this alternate mode. And then it's got like music videos. I'm like, why? I looked at Bree. I was like, why did we pay $20-something to go to the theater and see this when we can have a better, it's not like it's a comparable experience. It's a better experience. And some of these movies get alternate cuts on, it'd be like, you know, the version you couldn't see, like the Justice League, not Justice League, Batman versus Superman, Dawn of Justice. Like when that came out, it was a different version. It's like an extended cut.
You know, ultimate. It's a struggle. It's definitely like you pick and choose now. I know for me, like me and my wife normally will go to the earliest show on the weekends because she travels a lot for work. So a lot of times it's going to be like a Saturday or Sunday. We're going to the movies on an opening weekend of a movie. Since, you know, with my podcast and YouTube channel, I cover the comic book movies. So most of the big comic book movies I go see opening weekend for review purposes. So we go to either the earliest show is normally around 10 o'clock. I know we have already bought tickets for Endgame, and we're going to like a 9:30 showing because they have so many showings that opening weekend. So it'll be at 9:30. But normally it's like 10 o'clock, 10:30 show. Mm-hmm. Tickets are $6.50 a piece.
Wow.
You know, if we go anytime later, I guess the matinee is goes up by $2. So it's like $8.50.
Wow.
So, again, then we're just really paying for food. Now, the one cool thing about Studio Movie Grill is that they don't have like AMC, they have their A-list stubs and all that kind of stuff. Uh-huh. It's not that detailed. They said, we've talked to a manager there because we go to that chain so much. I just like pulled them to the side one day. They have,
you push them against the wall.
No, yeah, like, come here, I need to talk to you. But they have a rewards program called SMG Rewards, where basically, like, when you order tickets in advance online, you don't get the convenience charge of $1.50 per ticket like you normally get. You earn points for purchasing movie tickets that then you get coupons that you can use towards your future movie tickets or when you order food at the theater.
Say that too. AMC does have that A-list. I think it's called the A-list program where you can, I think it's $10 a month or something like that. And you get three movies a week, I believe you can go see. And there are any movies anytime.
It's 20 a month.
Is it 20? Okay. Still,
in certain states, no, it went up. I just read an article in certain states, they went up. So it was started at $20. And I think in certain states it's 25 a month. It's still not horrible. I mean, if you're getting that many movies a month, you can potentially go, like I said, three a week.
If you want to go to AMC theaters three times a week, a bad deal.
I mean, I wouldn't personally do it, but, MoviePass was awesome before it kind of crumbled.
Yeah. It wasn't sustainable, though, because when they launched, I was like, there's no way this is going to last. It's just a weird time, you know, because like we were talking about, like I used to go to the theater so much and sometimes I miss it. Like I miss what that experience used to mean to me. Another chain that I hear a lot of great things about is the Alamo Drafthouse. So I want to shout them out because they have a stellar reputation. Like if you get a cell phone call in the middle of a movie and you take it, like you're in trouble with Alamo Drafthouse.
Yeah, I've heard they will kick you out.
Yeah,
and for real. Some locations here in Houston and all around because they originate from here, but now they're expanding, kind of like Studio right. Movie Girl, they're expanding out. And that was one thing me and my wife said, we have to try Alamo Draft House at some point. So it's, you know, I know it's a couple, maybe two or three here in the greater Houston area, and we had to just seek it out. But most of the time when I'm going to a movie, my movie theater is like 10 to 15 minutes away top, probably like 10 minutes away from us. Uh-huh. So it's just like easy to go. You know, we got our location, we go. But we both said we want to try out that Alamo Draft House to see, like, because I've heard people like, it's a transformative experience. So
yeah, and they do a lot of like classic movie screenings and things too, which obviously AMC doesn't really do that. They'll do those Fathom events from time to time where they'll have like you know, like a 2001 A Space Odyssey is turning 50 or whatever, and they'll do like a special screening of something like that at an AMC. But Alamo Drafthouse does these things all the time, showing classic movies or just like repertory screenings of things. But we don't have them. They're a small chain still, and they're not nearly close to being everywhere in all the big cities. So I hear good things, but I'm stuck with AMC, which is like the Walmart of theaters without the low prices. People barefoot? No, not really. But
yeah, it's a shame because AMC used to have. I mean, I remember as a kid, AMC were like the movies, the theater to go to, the chain to go through. If you were, you know, especially like me, originally growing up in Connecticut, like AMC was like the theater chain that you would go to. Like that was the go-to, and it's so different now. You know, as they've become so huge, like you said, they've taken over a lot of places, not put the money, reinvested the money back in to improve those places, just to have the locations. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's so weird, and it goes back to what you said with the home theater experience, which you can do the investment that you can do upgrade. You know, like I said, if you want to upgrade your TV or have a decent TV and good player and the setups you can have at home for a relatively reasonable price, and then you're comfortable. You can pause it. Like you said, the windows between, you know, home theater, I mean, from movie theater to home theater now is less and less, and it's even lesser if you do digital, because now you have, it'll hit digital first, and then a couple of weeks later, you get the home theater, you know, the home movie release of the DVD or Blu-ray. It's still, the window is short, because like we said, Aquaman came out right around Christmas time. That, Into the Spider-Verse, they all came out 1 week after the other. Mm-hmm. Mary Poppins, all of that. All those movies that came out at the end of December, Christmas time, all what, hit home video within the past month?
Within the last month, and now they're all on sale.
So a couple of months later, like I said, I literally, most of the movies you mentioned, like, I didn't get a chance to see Creed 2 at the theater. I've just bought that for like $10, mm-hmm. Maybe 2 weeks ago. I bought Aquaman for $12.99 a week ago. I was gifted Into the Spider-Verse.
Yeah. Who did that? Who sent you that?
Who did that?
I don't know who did that.
Mary Poppins, same thing. All of those movies like are recent releases. So, I mean, if you can wait 2 months, you can get that experience. And if you have a good setup, you know, I wish I could flip the camera around and kind of show you, like, here in my office, I have I got a 55-inch 1080.
You get a 55-inch TV now for, like, $27.
Well, I'm saying, you know what I mean? Like, for real, it's so funny that now, like, they're so inexpensive. Even we upgraded in our living room last year around this time, got a 4K TV, 65 or 70-inch for $650.
Wow.
Something like that, $650.
That's four movies at AMC.
Exactly, you know. So we did that, and I mean, it was and beautiful 4K. That's 4K TV. We got the since I do digital primarily, the 4K Apple TV. Mm-hmm. You know, did a whole setup for less than $1,000. Surround sound bar, with subwoofer and the whole nine. I think everything was like maybe $1,100 altogether. Nice, just, you know, set up in the living room. So when we have company, or sometimes we got the reclining chairs in there, reclining love seat at the ends or whatever, and we just kick back. And like when we do a movie day, that's what we do, go to the living room and watch it there. But then even in the bedroom and in my office, they're both like 55. I think one's a 55, one's a 60 inch. Have a nice little sound bar. My sound bar here in the office has two satellite side speakers and a subwoofer. And then it's just a regular sound bar in the bedroom, and fine. I enjoy watching my movies just fine off of those TVs, and they're just as equal to, like you said, any experience you're going to have in a theater, or better, because you're in the comfort of your own home, and you can get those special features and all that. And if you need to take a bathroom break, you're not missing an important part of the movie. Just pause. You know?
Yeah.
So, I don't know.
It's become more, it's a bigger question than I think it's ever been before, because the options are so, home theater experience can often be better than the theatrical experience, but you still have to wait a couple of months or 3 months or whatever it is. So, but I don't know. I know a lot of people have stopped going to the theater so much. And so I'm just wondering what the community thinks about this topic, and if they're still going to the theater as much as they used to. Where can they find you?
You can find me over at youtube.com/comicbooksavant. And you can always go to my website, comicbooksavant.com. Everything related to me is there, the social medias, all that fun stuff. Either one of those two places, you can find it all there.
Are you wearing your own merchandise? You got a Comic Book Savant t-shirt?
Yes, I got a merch store, Teespring merch store up. So I do now have actual Comic Book Savant t-shirts. So if you like, you can purchase. Links are on the website and in the YouTube stuff, so you can find them.
Guys, thank you so much for hanging out with us and watching this video, for weighing in on this topic. It's a big one, but we appreciate you. We appreciate your time. And James, thank you, man. I appreciate this.
No problem. Love it.
All right, guys, we will catch you later.